In this
yeah, because I thought it's going to be a Hokkien song, but it's actually English.
Why is it very
emotional?
Oh, we are not talking about Hokkien song now.
Happy talk show.
Talking about why is the state of Singapore's affair like that nowadays? Like every morning, you don't know whether the MRT going to break down or not. You have to take precautions.
Okay,
now.
The thing is, I think it's a good thing for Singaporeans. You know why? Okay, think about this.
Yeah, sure.
Every country, they have their natural disasters.
Right.
Right. And then Singapore is like, we are too protected, too sheltered.
Yeah. Too sheltered.
And then sometimes, I even have this conspiracy theory. Probably this was done on purpose. I mean, conspiracy theory lah. I mean, I'm thinking like, if I am a minister, let's say I'm the prime minister, right? I want my nation to be strong and resilient. I must ask myself, what can I do to make them, you know, be a resilient nation? So I'm thinking, like, for example, there was this ex-student of mine on my Facebook. So he was writing, I'm going to prepare for MRT tomorrow.
Prepare for MRT breakdown tomorrow.
Yes, and then he came out with different bus routes. So to me, this is actually a good thing. I mean, if we are very negative, all we will do is we will blame Mr. Liu Tak Yew. Why are you not doing?
That's right.
So for me, I don't know. People might say I'm a hypocrite because what? Look at who.
Look at the camera. Yeah, that's right.
Okay, because I like to look at you, lah, Roger.
We are not talking to me, you know.
You're too handsome.
Yeah,
you're being my wife.
Right. I know.
Don't
change the topic. The topic tonight. So better stay with that. No, I'm just saying that look in the camera. We are not talking among ourselves only.
Okay, but the camera here, I just tell the audience. The viewers is too tiny and they don't know it's a camera.
Like facing with crisis, right? Handle crisis positively.
Crisis positively.
I fully agree with you. Great. I think it's not just a conspiracy theory. It is true.
Yes, it's true. I mean, if it's really something that really happened, then it's good for us. You know, but for me, people might think I'm a hypocrite because I don't really take public transport. But when I was in university, I would take rides worth of 3 hours to and fro to NUS. So I know the condition. Like sometimes, I have to rush because I would take from Clementi or Boon Lay. So last time I was in NIE, so I had to take from Boon Lay. It's very packed because you have the factory workers and then peak hours. I know how tough it was. So for me, I knew I had no choice. So what I did was I listened to my MP3 player or I go and look at my smartphone. That time I used the palm, you know, the palm. But now I think the company shut down already. So that palm I will use, like, for example, I will read up my scientific journals. You know, I mean, it's like
use your
That
was what I just said, right? Earlier on, before you came.
Talking about this, right? I had this conversation about what topic, and then someone mentioned to me, if there's anything this person wish for, right? The trains. That people bathe before they get on the trains.
Please.
You know the bauketia and all this. Yeah. Like, ayoh, boleh mati lah.
Correct. My wife took the buses and MRTs. I mean, like a few months ago, because of want to introduce my children to public transport. So she said that people just let go of gases from their body, and then they smell. I mean, I think it's a good thing for us. I mean, it's like. I mean, even this small little thing like smelly, right? I mean, you think
morning still not so bad. I was after work in the office, and that sweat after school.
All the hair goes
smell. What can you do? You can't expect everyone to shower just before they get on the trains, right?
Yes. Helps people to understand that they are people of many kinds. Like you have to be tolerant.
I don't know. There's this like those air fresheners. Maybe SMRT or whatever
can
SBS Transit can install in the train carriage.